Hello everyone, I am Omkar from the Energy and Resources Institute, New Delhi, and C2P2, which is the climate credit pilot phase, is part of the Project Surya Consortium, which includes TERI, then University of California, San Diego, and Nextleaf Analytics, NGO based out of USA that works on digital solutions. So Project Surya was started in 2009 by this consortium, and as part of this project, now we have this project basically likes to it has two purpose. One is to see if the rural households that use the traditional stoves, if we have to change their behavior in term and want them to use, say, cleaner technologies, improved cook stoves or LPG electric stoves, then what could be the ways for getting this adoption in process. So adoption in any ways is a big challenge right now in rural areas, be it toilets, be it these kind of improved stores or any new technology. So from that adoption perspective, the project was started. The other important part, as you can see, it's called climate credit because apart from the carbon finance that includes CO2 and other Kyoto gases, we are also trying to include the short-lived climate pollutants into this particular climate credit calculations. So a short-lived climate pollutant is black carbon is one of the important element of SLCPs, and black carbon is also the second largest pollutant after carbon dioxide, a global warming agent. And what we are trying to do is we had done some field calculations, some data has been collected, and based on that we have constructed our own algorithm to calculate these climate credits, which include SLCPs as well as CO2. So why clean cook stoves? Globally, around 2.8 billion people cook with traditional fuels and stoves, and more than 50% premature deaths of children before 5, they are happening because of these kind of soot or It cannot be directly linked to soot, but it is indoor air pollution, and which can be attributed to inefficient stoves and kerosene lamps. And then again, when we introduce clean stoves, the government of India and all over the world, there have been many programs to promote improved stoves or cleaner fuels, and all of them have failed at some point or the other, or they have just run in a project mode because the adoption in some ways was not triggered. One of the main causes was affordability. People didn't want to pay because their traditional stove comes for free. They can construct it for free. So even if you're asking them to pay, say, 20 or 50 or whatever dollars of money for these kind of cleaner solutions, they are not ready to do it. And it's obvious that if they feel that they are not comfortable with it, then we need a change management idea to get this going. And so we started C2P2, which was an initiative, as I told you. And in that, what we are trying to do is that if we want to give climate credits, or if we want to reward the women in a rural area with money or climate credits for using the cook stove or say solar light, then we need a mechanism to verify it. Currently, surveys are being used to verify it, and it is not a foolproof methodology. Again, with cook stoves, the problem is that if you test it in the laboratory, the reductions that you see are almost 90%, like over 80% of reductions you can see with the improved stove. Because in the laboratory, you are using all kinds of best fuels and the conditions and the way you are cooking. But in rural areas, it's not like in actual kitchen as well. You cook different dishes, then you sometimes you have moisture in your fuel. So there are many factors. So this soot swap application that was developed, what it does is that you can connect this soot swap application, what it does is it helps in tracking the cook stove usage in the households, and it sends data through the SIM card that is there in the mobile phone, or even now we are working on a system where people can message an encrypted code on the stove, which has a circuit, a sensor connected to the stove. And this way, we can calculate it in real time, how much cook stove usage has been there, and we can calculate the amount of money that the house has earned, and we have linked it to rural banks, and it gets transferred directly to the loan accounts from which they have bought. Like, they have taken micro loans for buying the stores, and this money gets transferred directly to their account. So it helps in paying back the loans. So that kind of business model we have been working. Also, we are working with Gold Standard and other organization to get this methodology into a registered methodology, a protocol that can be used going forward apart from the current protocol of CO2, so that people can benefit even more than what they're currently earning. So these are the uniqueness and impacts of the project that I already mentioned them, that we are trying to develop a methodology that can go in the Gold Standard or a similar protocol, so that it can become a scalable model and it can work as a business model where people can get incentivized for using cleaner technologies.
How many people have been impacted? Is there, we haven't seen any numbers here. Is it something in the conceptual stage, or is it being?
No. We already have started a pilot, and we are currently up to 500 households, and we have just received a fund for taking it to 5,000 households. So currently the climate credits that we are giving, those are not linked to the actual markets. This is through a fund that we have created, and parallelly we are developing the protocol. So the data that we are collecting through this data will be then used to develop that protocol, and once it goes in the protocol, then it can be traded directly on the market. I also have a short video if
I think time. We need to place because you're running out of time.
Okay.
Yeah. Could I take some questions if there are any?
Onkar, if I understood one of your points correctly, you are kind of dependent on a lot of your things going on mobile, and somebody being literate enough to actually type an encrypted code. Right?
Yes.
But if we go down to the villages where the actual soot chula is used, right? I see certain challenges. Like, first, the understanding of literacy could be very different. That mobiles are primarily English or at best Hindi in terms of the type. Right? But let's say somebody is literate only in Tamil. Then how will he kind of figure out the encrypted code?
So when we currently have started this project with smartphones, and there's an application. SuitSwap is a Android-based application, and the end user don't have to do anything. It gets connected. A smartphone gets connected to the store, and it keeps transferring data. That's why we entered it in the science and technology category, because we are currently studying the adoption patterns. And this data that we are getting, the end users are not involved. But going forward, since smartphones cannot be given to each and every household, we have funds for, say, 1,000 households or 5,000 households. So going forward, what we have decided is that the temperature sensor would have a small display which would come with the store, and you can message it from your registered mobile number. So it would be a number that you have to register from your mobile to a number that we have given. And that this is not this is a normal number, 3257 or something. So there's no language barrier as such involved. You can just message that number, and you can message it maybe daily. In 15 days, it can store the data up to 6 months. So even in 6 months, if somebody goes there and helps everybody message it, it would serve the purpose. But the basic idea is that we get a platform where we have the actual data to understand why people are not adopting it, and if people are using it, then how we can give them the credits directly into their account.
Okay. All right. Thank you. Okay. Thank you, Omkar. I think we need to move to the next presenter.